Hello, Corvo. Your life has taken a turn, has it not? The Empress is dead. Her precious daughter, Emily, is lost somewhere in the city, and you will play a pivotal role in the days to come. For this, I have chosen you and drawn you into the void. I am the outsider, and this is my mark. There are forces in the world and beyond the world. Great forces that we call magic. And now, these forces will serve your will. Use this newfound power. My gift to you. Come find me. Days that follow, your trials will be great, Corvo. Seek the ancient runes bearing my mark in the lonely places of your world, and at shrines raised in my name. These runes will grant you powers beyond those of other men. To help you find these runes, I give you this, the heart of a living thing, molded by my hands. With this heart, you will hear many secrets, and it will guide you toward my runes, no matter how they may be hidden. Listen to the heart now, and find another rune. Thank you. How you use what I have given you falls upon you, as it has to the others before you. And now I return you to your world, but know that I will be watching with great interest.
Attention Dunwall citizens, do not attempt to house or care for a friend or family member who shows signs of blood on their face and chest area. The only way to help them is to bring them to the city watch. They will be taken to the flooded district for treatment.
Should I clear space for Samuel then? Good day, Master Corvo.
I had a sailor for a boyfriend once. He thought he'd strike gold digging in the Pandician cliffs. They found his ship drifting empty.
Lydia and I trade chores sometime. And I'm starting to think I never come out ahead. She's a smart one.
Well, let's get down to it. First off, I know that assassination is dark business. But sometimes, good men have to do bad things to make the world right. Our purpose is clear. We want to restore Her Majesty's line by finding and putting Emily Caldwin on the throne. To those ends, we'll hide, act in shadow, take them apart, piece by piece. Tonight, High Overseer Campbell dies by your hand. It won't be easy. He's protected by his overseers, an army of religious zealots. But if anyone can do it, you can. Your exploits are legendary. Campbell carries a private journal. Once you've eliminated him, get the journal, because we think it contains Emily's location. Recovering her is obviously critical, assuming she's alive. That's the gist of it. Remember our cause and strike true. We're counting on you. Another thing. Campbell is holding a former overseer by the name of... He's one of us, and if you manage to find him, give him whatever help you can. He's a master strategist, and he got caught working for our cause. It'd be good to have him back here around.
Thank you. Just wondering, sir, if you thought about perhaps seeing Piero before venturing into the Overseer's Nest. I'd recommend going with the best gear you can get together.
Okay. Corvo. Hello. I'm Callista. I work here for Admiral Havelock. I'm sorry to intrude on your business, but this is important. I suspect you're going to kill the High Overseer. That wretched man. There's really no reason for you to listen to me. But my uncle, Jeff Kernow, still serves as captain in the City Watch. But he's a good man, and my only family. The chatter in servant circles is that Campbell just took delivery of an exotic poison. And I think I know why. My uncle's not corruptible like the rest of them. Campbell is going to poison my uncle. Do you think you could protect him? You used to do that, right? Before you had your current profession. Before you became an assassin. I overheard the Admiral at breakfast, talking about the Overseers. That's all I heard.
Keeps beating, does that
I think
mean
it's better if I don't know too much about
never
what people are doing.
Into oblivion. I can keep a heart beating forever with electricity, but what does that mean?
What can I do for you?
Ready to go? Just give the signal. It'll be a rough trip. Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. Then there are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. I don't know which is worse. Just take your pick. If you decide to go up Clavering, don't let the guards spot you.
Let's go. It's nearly midnight. But easy, damn. Got enough shit in it as it is.
Hey!
What is it?
I think that last one was moving.
What?
Yeah, the little one.
Not possible. I inspected them myself. Keep working.
Well, he ain't moving no more.
Sit still.
Designated a restricted travel area. Any citizens are liable to search or imprisonment at the discretion of the City Watch. Attention, Dunwall citizens. This is a special announcement from our honorable Lord Regent.
This is the Lord Regent speaking. It is with regret that I announce that my term as Lord Regent has been extended through the month.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Report all deceased family members to the local dead counter. Unreported deaths are a punishable offense.
I think the little birdies are sad today. Dear? Is that you, my dear husband? My eyes aren't what they used to be. Have you seen my little birdies? Oh, the dear things must be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here. Oh, my, my, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either. Granny Rags, let us in. Ah, well, they'll go away again if they know what's good for them, but what a bother. Here's the key to the front door, love. You'll see to those ruffians, won't you? I told you the knives go on the left.
Let us in, Granny.
Would you look?
It was one of the first to die of the plague.
Come on, let's get this. I'm gonna dump you in the river after I kill you.
Granny, you can't because you're dead. Oh, my dear, I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave man. Listen, Granny has a birthday present for you. I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you. Go on, it's upstairs, on the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it. Remember how we used to dance? Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to come. If I was a birdie, I'd love to eat that. Yes, I would, indeed. I told you the knives go on the left. They've always gone on the left.
You never leave.
I hope you like the little gift I got for you. It's the least I could do for turning those louts away. I can't bear these Bottle Street children. Ruffians, every last one of them. Rotten apples. And that slack jaw is the worst of the lot. You know what I just thought of? You could do something else for me. Another little favor. And I'd give you another present. Another lovely rune carved from the bones of a dead whale. Do you remember my doctor, dear? Dr. Galvani? Now there was a clever man. He's got all sorts of nasty rat guts and disease in his laboratory. Wouldn't it be a shame if some of that mess found its way into the Bottle Street gang's elixir still? Teach him. See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first. Galvani lives on Clavering Boulevard, or at least he used to. Those were the days. Now run off. My baby birdies are hungry. So precious. But they're shy. You'll have to go, or they won't come. Get out. Chew.
Be careful, Corvo. They call her Granny Rags. You wouldn't recognize her real name, or even the name of her family. But an emperor begged for her hand once, and rich young men fought each other for her favor. I watched her consider them all, measure their worth, and find them wanting. Then, she made a different choice. You're on your way to face the High Overseer, the leader of a great cult dedicated to loathing me. What will you do, I wonder?
Work to do. Off you go.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Please clear the area. when a motorized carriage or stilt walker approaches on state business. Be advised that such vehicles will not slow or stop to avoid citizens obstructing the way.
I owe you, brother. I won't ask about the mask. I wouldn't want my face seen either, pulling a stunt like that.
You know what? I'll return the favor. Come by Griff's shop. That's my business. Well, it was, at one time. But now I'm reduced to scavenging things from here and there as the city dies. If you need anything, I wouldn't mind trading for a little money. Maybe someday the plague will blow over and everything will go back to normal. But until then, it's scavenging for me. Huh?
Attention, Dunwall citizens. John Clavering Boulevard has been designated a restricted travel area. Any citizens are liable to search or imprisonment at the discretion of the City Watch.
You're gonna bleed.
Die.
What the fuck?
was that?
Come on! Let's get this guy!
You can't fight for shit! Watch it! Go down!
Any chance you'll share your food with me tonight?
Please.
Get him done already! Take it! Break him! Die!
Did you touch the door?
Something. Help!
Obviously, the plague rat is different from the ordinary rat. But in what respect? Its size and the coarseness of its fur. I believe in intelligence. Although the experiments there are not complete. Coriander's zoological survey describes only the ordinary rat, which means plague rats have only been here for 5 or 7 years at most. This was not a gradual migration. Could they have been introduced? Purpose? Perhaps by a foreign power.
Keep away, or I'll slit your record for you. Get off, blowhard. Square up. Got this guy. Oh, I'll find him. Hey, dead body.
I knew you wouldn't disappoint me. Now I can stroll along the waterfront in peace. And don't think I've forgotten your little gift. Go on upstairs, dear one. That will never work. I told him, peel it off. Peel it off so it can breathe. That will never wash. Never, never, never.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Please clear the area. When a motorized carriage or stilt walker approaches on state business, be advised that such vehicles will not slow or stop to avoid citizens obstructing the way.
The second day is when the skin really starts to come all the way off. Is that true? Or is it the...
What a sight you are in that mask. I know who you are and what you're here to do. And I can help. Feels good to stand up straight. Thank you, Corvo. What you're here to do tonight is of the highest importance. We've got to find Emily, so kill Campbell and make it quick. Once it's done, search his body for the journal, his notorious black book, and get out of there. Campbell is meeting with a guard named Kernow, and word from my informant is that Campbell is going to poison him. Maybe you can use that to your advantage. All right, I won't be of any help here, so I'll make my own way back to the Hound Pit. If I see Samuel the boatman, I'll tell him to pick you up in the backyard, behind the office of the High Overseer. May all the spirits guide you. His head hit the floor without you taking a scratch.
Archive about the heretic's brand. It sounds painful. Have you ever seen the rich?
I've never seen the heretic's brand used. No, it's a rich. But I did spy the face of one so branded. A former member of our order, of course.
Out on a retreat, we passed through a fishing town and saw the bait.
Where are you? When I find you, it's gonna be bad.
Now, get behind him. Take him. Get going down. Now what?
After what happened last night.
Quiet night, is it?
What was that?
Feed your heart.
to the beginning. It was Martin's plot to break him out of Coldridge Prison. That's clear enough. But why Corvo? The one man feared throughout the Empire. He's as bloody-minded as they say. Left a trail of bodies. The way he died.
Besides, a bunch of children playing games, that's all it is.
Good, good. And your niece, Callista, isn't it? I'm very concerned.
She'll be found. My men are searching district by district.
Servants must have been in here. Let me see. It seems I have the wrong one. Not that one. No. Ah, here we are. Now if you'll join me. Men will come get you when we're finished. Keep each other entertained in the meantime.
I don't understand how this got so unpleasant.
Oh, I agree, I agree. A whore dies and suddenly this. Will you have wine? It's a Tivian Red.
Thank you.
Now, to business. What would you say happened last night?
To be honest, I'm not even sure. My men, your overseers, a few whores, maybe a little too much ale. One harmless prank with a runaway chicken, and 10 minutes later, Trevor's Alley is a sea of blood and teeth.
I almost wish I'd been there.
Take it easy there, old son.
I'm all right, Colonel. Went down the wrong way. Now about these overseers.
Who are just as guilty as my own men, if not more.
But my overseers have a name to protect. I can't allow you to... Oh, no. This can't be happening. Who's done this?
What on earth are you talking about?
No time, no time. Listen carefully. You must... instruct the Lord Regent to burn the Black Book. Understand? Burn it!
What Black Book? What do you mean?
Tell him. Warn them. And then die of plague, you useless incompetent! I never liked you!
What the... Campbell? He's dead.
Guards! Guards, get in here!
By the prophecies. What have you done?
He's been poisoned. The...
Fire!
Now...
Okay, hold it!
overseers always find the guild they seek.
Hey, Corvo. It's Samuel. I'm here. From the way I hear it, Campbell lived a pretty posh life. Maybe it's not my place to say, but men of the faith shouldn't live like barons. Are you ready to go? Okay, let's go. Admiral Havelock and Lord Pendleton are in the courtyard. I expect they'll want to congratulate you.
He's alive. Thank you, Corvo. Thank you. My uncle's a good man, and one day he'll prove it. Here. I know you did this for the right reasons. but I want you to take this as a reward. It's an old heirloom one of my aunts gave me.
They're all corrupt. If this is going to work, we have to take down the Lord Regent and all of his kiosks.
Living on the north side of the river.
You did it! Somehow you took down the High Overseer Campbell against the odds. I knew you were our man, Corvo. With Campbell gone, we've hurt the Lord Regent immeasurably. And with Martin back, we'll have the finest strategist alive.
The Lord Regent must be shitting himself in Dunwall Tower.
Yes, and Campbell's journal, let's not forget. Our hope is that in these encoded pages, the location and condition of Emily Caldwin can be discovered. Our entire movement will mean nothing if we can't place the rightful heir on the throne. We must act fast. No doubt the Lord Regent is holding Emily somewhere, waiting to reveal her, to step out as the hero and further cement his regency.
If he doesn't bring the young lady forth soon, there will be infighting among the nobles as to who should succeed the Empress.
Yes, time is against us. But now you should take a well-earned rest, Corvo. We will decipher the contents of the High Overseer's journal and share them with you later. Sometimes I think this conspiracy feels like the start of a joke, don't you? An admiral, an aristocrat, and an overseer walk into a bar. I wonder what the punchline will be.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. You are reminded that assaulting a member of the City Watch has been made a capital offense. And guardsmen are authorized to carry out this sentence on the spot. The offender's possessions are legally forfeited.